Hello, my name is Vincent from AirGunsEurope.com, and in this video I'd love to tell you something about the Wall-Terrain PCP rifle. Now, the Wall-Terrain is a bullpup PCP rifle made by the Humorex company in Germany. It's really one of the most short and lightweight bullpup configurations you can find on the market today. It's mostly covered in a polymer, and I say polymer because it doesn't feel like a cheap plastic or anything. It's got this really nice texture on its forearm and pistol grip, and because of the pistol grip and the fact that this rifle only weighs 2.5 kilograms, it's really easy to carry it around in the field all day with just using one hand. So it is a perfect lightweight air rifle. It is still quite powerful. The one I have right here is a 6.35 millimeter, now, or 0.25. With this caliber you could have a maximum muscle energy of up to 70 joule with a maximum muscle velocity of 280 meters per second. So it is quite a powerful air rifle. It's totally ambidextrous, so both good for left and right-handed shooters, because you can take the sight lever off and place it on the other side of the air rifle. And also it does come with a really nice well-made magazine which you can insert from both ends of the air rifle, making it perfectly adaptable for every shooter. Now, like I said, it's quite a powerful rifle. It's really lightweight. It's not that long. It has got a 22 millimeter Picatinny rail above on which you can mount a scope. This one's made out of high grade aluminum, and also the barrel is shrouded, it's anodized, and it's threaded for half UNF. So it is a silencer, but you can add an extra silencer if you would take the end cap off, making it a really quiet air rifle. It has a 22 millimeter Picatinny rail at the bottom over here, on which you could mount like a flashlight, a front grip, or a bipod. It's got a two-stage adjustable trigger. To adjust the trigger, you can't do it by placing an Allen key in the trigger guard, but you have to do it from the back of the air rifle. Now, in the manual, it says you would have to take the whole side plate off to access the trigger, but it's quite easy actually. If you take these three Allen keys out, screws out, you can take the butt plate off, and then you can see two holes on which you can adjust the trigger with. So it's a two-stage adjustable trigger. It comes with a really nice magazine, also comes with a Walter fill probe which you can connect right over here if you take the dust cap off. I will be showing you that later on. Nice thing about it is that it's got the meter on the side of the air rifle. It also says the maximum fill pressure of the air rifle, which is 232 bar. And the meter is a bit covered, so when you would drop it or anything like that, you won't damage it. So that's really well thought of. It's got the crossbolt safety, it's manual safety above the trigger over here. Now, like I said, you would have to mount a scope on it because it hasn't got any open sights, but you could also fix like a red dot sight because it's really easy and fun to use if you would use it for rapid fire. It's got a really nice and smooth sight lever system, which is held together when you close it by two magnets which are on the lever as well. Like I said, you could place it on the left side of the air rifle. Some right-handed shooters would prefer that as well, so they can keep their hand on the trigger guard and then load it like this. Yeah, let me show you how to fill it and how to load it. Okay, right now, so to fill the air rifle, you would have to take this dust cap out. It already says what's the maximum fill pressure is. It's 232 bar. I don't really believe that I have enough pressure inside of my own diver's bottle to fill it all the way, but I can show you how to. You simply connect the fill probe, which came with the air rifle, to your diver's bottle, plug it in there as far as it can go, and then open the valve slowly. And then this meter goes up. This is the one you would look at. Now, of course, you could do this with a hand pump as well, but yeah, this is way easier, especially if you tend to shoot a lot. That should be it. Close it, and then always don't forget to degas the hose by pushing a button. Now the pressure is off the hose, simply take this one out, put the dust cap in there, And then this rifle is filled and ready to shoot. Now we would have to load the magazine. I already mounted the scope. I particularly like these scopes. This is a Part NV008. This is a digital scope which you can use by daytime but also at night. It's got an infrared light on there. Really clear image. I also mounted the front grip, which also is a bipod. They make these from Walter. They're not that expensive. Of course, you can fit on any other type of bipod as well, but yeah, for this type of air rifle, it looks pretty cool and it's handy. Now, let me show you how to load the magazine. Okay, so this is the 9-shot rotary magazine from Walter. It's a really simple design, but it works perfectly. You can't really go wrong with it because it has an arrow saying which side was the front. You could place it inside of the arrow from both sides, just as I mentioned earlier. And to load it, it works perfect because with some PCP rifles, they tend to have magazines which aren't that pellet friendly because you really have to push and place it in the right place to get the pellet inside of the magazine. With this type of magazine, you just place it in and that goes really loosely. So you're almost afraid that the pellets will fall out of the magazine from the other side, but they added this small catch over here, so it can't fall through because of this small plate which has a spring. Now, when you put the magazine inside of the air rifle, it places this out of the way, and then of course when the lever will push the pellet outside of the magazine, then it can freely place it inside of the barrel. Really good system, easy to load. You just wind it up like this, placing 9 pellets in there in the 6.35 mm. The ones I have right here are the JSB heavies, JSB Exact King heavy to be precise. A really fine pellet for this type of air rifle, but you could also use others as long as you got the right caliber. Now that's it basically. Then you would pull the lever back, cocking the hammer really smooth. And then you can choose from which side you would want to place the magazine in there. You could do it from this side or the other, maybe depending if you're a left or right-handed shooter. Now let's take it to the range. Okay, so we already loaded up the magazine, which was quite easy. To place it inside the air rifle, you can't really go wrong with that because there's an arrow indexing the front. You could place it in from both sides of the air rifle. First of all, you have to cock it, of course. We'll place it in from this side just to try that. When you push the lever forward, it takes a pellet inside of the barrel, holds it closely together because of the two magnets which are on the lever. Now it's ready to shoot. It's got the crossbolt safety, which is that button. Now it deactivated the trigger, and then when you push it from this side, then it's armed again. Let me try and shoot it from the left hand. I am a right-handed shooter, so it's not my best option, but it works. It's quite a joy to shoot because it's got a really light lever. The trigger is pretty good actually. You could always make it more lighter, but straight out of the box, it is an okay trigger. Of course, it does make a little bit of noise, although the barrel is shrouded and silenced. Now, you could put on an extra silencer. Let me take the magazine out first. Because of the sound, when you fire it without pellets, that's about the noise you get. Take this off. The barrel is threaded for half UNF, like I mentioned earlier. Now, you could fit on any type of silencer you want. I've got a really nice silencer from Gammo, which is the same anodized black color as the shroud of the barrel is, so that looks pretty cool. Also, we've got these silencers from Donny FL, which are considered to be the best, but they're a bit more expensive as well, of course. This is the Donny FL Sumu. Works pretty great on this air rifle, and it's still quite compact, so it's not that that long when you add this silencer on it. Also half UNF, and when you hear it now, hardly makes any noise at all. And with pellet, it's even more quiet. Now, if you're interested in the Walter Rain or in any other air rifle, you could freely contact us by phone or by mail, or you could come and visit our store in the Netherlands. When you order online, we ship across Europe. Any questions, feel free to ask. And I hope you enjoyed the video. All right, see you next time. Thank you for watching.